الصبح بدا من طلعته والليل دجى من وفرته فأقر رسلا فضلا وعلا أهدى السبل بدلالته فأقر رسلا فضلا وعلا أهدى السبل بدلالته الله 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 الله
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Peace and salutations be upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Respected viewers of ITV Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh Welcome to another edition of the program Riyad Us Saliheen Gardens of the Righteous And we give a warm welcome to day 8 of the blessed month of Ramadan MashaAllah what a beautiful month we are experiencing So many mercies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and blessings descend upon each and every one of us and indeed we are grateful and thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we hope that we're doing our level best to capitalize on every single moment an opportunity of doing good in the blessed month of Ramadan. Never let an opportunity pass by you of this grand sale from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that has started a week ago and will continue for the next 3 weeks inshallah. Every good deed that we do is multiplied so much more. Every cent that we spend in this month of Ramadan is multiplied so much more by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we have an opportunity to fill our scale of good deeds as much as we possibly can in this month of Ramadan. On the last edition of the program, Riyad Us Saliheen, currently we were discussing the chapter of patience and we were discussing a quotation of Umar radiallahu anhu, the great companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, regarding patience. And he said that never did I go through any difficulty or hardship except that I found three benefits and three positives in that difficulty or the hardship that had come upon me. And he said, number one, I would appreciate the fact that the difficulty or hardship that had come upon me had not affected my faith and my religion in any way. That's what he would focus on. And number two, he said that whenever difficulty or hardship came upon me, then I would also thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and appreciate the fact that the problem that had come upon me was not worse than what it was. Because every single difficulty and hardship that we experience, every problem that we face, every challenge that has overcome us could have been a lot more worse than what it is right now. And as I mentioned, and I'll repeat it again, sometimes we hear the statement, sometimes we even make it ourselves. When a problem comes upon us, we say, what could have happened? What worse could have happened to us? It's the worst thing that we're ever experiencing. There's nothing that could have been worse than this. Remember, that statement is false because every difficulty that you face definitely could have been a lot more worse than what it is right now. In fact, every problem that we face could have been multiplied by many other problems simultaneously. How would we then be able to bear that difficulty or hardship? If, for example, a person is tested, let's say with the loss of hearing, but they are still able to see. So now being unable to hear is a great challenge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it could have been worse if you were unable to hear and see at the same time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only gave you one test. He could have given you two. And if you have two tests upon you, He could have given you three. And if you have three, it could have been four. And like that, we can go on and go on explaining that. Every difficulty or challenge that you face could have most definitely been worse than what it is right now. And it could have been perhaps longer upon you than what it is right now. Sometimes we enjoyed so many years of goodness, prosperity, not many difficulties or challenges coming upon us. And then we go through a patch or a lean patch of difficulty and hardship where some problems or challenges come upon us and we are facing that. So now just because it's a duration of a period of time, sometimes maybe it's a few months, maybe it's a few years, then we become complacent again and we become so upset and we become so depressed that what worse could have happened to me? I'm suffering for so long. Is it that you really have been suffering for so long, or is it that perhaps for a longer duration of your existence in this world, you were enjoying privileges and mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Something for us to think about. Let's reflect in this month of Ramadan. It's a month to connect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a month for us to get a better of understanding of many things in our deen. And on this program, that is our aim and objective, for us to connect ourselves with the divine teachings of the Blessed Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that's the second thing, the benefit that Umar radiallahu anhu would look at when he would go through a challenge, a difficulty, that is the challenge of the problem could have been worse than what it is right now. And the 13 Umar radiallahu anhu says that whenever a difficulty or problem came upon me, I would remind myself that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised immense and grand reward for those people that are patient. وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. That's the statement that we need to continue repeating and we need to become familiar with. Whenever you're going through a hardship, whenever you're going through a difficulty, whatever it is, whether it came out of nowhere, whether you're experiencing it for a period of time, whether it's short term, whether it's long term, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. That's what you need to focus on. Keep that in front of you at all times. In fact, it's easy to memorize these words. وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Allah has given the best of glad tidings to those that are patient. وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Allah has given the best of glad tidings to those that are patient. Continuously remind yourself. You go to visit somebody else that's in a problem, or somebody is facing the same challenge with you. Together as a family, the problem has come upon the whole household. Remind each other. وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. That Allah has given the greatest or the best of glad tidings to those people that are patient. And at the same time, if we want to assist ourselves a little bit more, remember the statement of the Quran, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Alladhina idha asabathum musiba. Allah says that those who, whenever they are tested with any difficulty or hardship, when a problem afflicts them, قالوا, they make the statement, they proclaim, they cry out, they shout out, they say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. To Allah we belong and to Allah is our return. Immediately we turn our attention and our focus to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are few things that inshallah we can keep in mind and maybe we can start practicing upon. So even in the month of Ramadan, sometimes maybe the fast is getting a bit too difficult for us to bear. Somebody is testing your patience, somebody is trying to provoke you, they're trying to make you lose your cool. That's a difficulty or hardship that's coming upon you. That's a problem, that's a challenge. Now you need to be patient. You need to be patient in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and at the same time you need to be patient by you abstaining from that which displeases Allah. So now you're going through a challenge, so you need to remind yourself when somebody is trying to test your patience, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given the greatest of blessings and rewards and glad tidings to those people that are patient. So maybe we can remind each other at home as well in the month of Ramadan, if somebody is getting on somebody else's nerves or we're provoking one another in some way or the other, politely remind the other, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. You're trying to provoke me, you're trying to make me upset. Allah has given the best of glad tidings to those that are patient. So let's remind ourselves, inshallah. And when we do that, we'll see a lot of benefit and goodness, inshallah. That brings us to the end of today's edition of the program, Riyad Us Saliheen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
الليل دجى من وفرته فأقر رسلا فضلا وعلا أهدى السبلا بدلالته فأقر رسلا فضلا وعلا أهدى السبلا بدلالته الله الله الله.